Welcome to the Glasgow farm. That's right. If you have a horn, feel free to use it right now. One more time. Okay. Praise the Lord. That's what that means, okay? So I'm the Dale Glasgow, pastor of the Glasgow Farm Church, and this is my wife, Sharon, a pastor as well. And we welcome you all to our candlelight service for this year, 2020. We're going to go out with a great bang today, tonight, with praising the Lord. And baby Jesus is going to be visiting us as well. I'm going to have to work on my goat in a minute. She's very unhappy. Her head is stuck. So if you all would pray with me right now. Lord God, we thank you for bringing us all here together on this night. And God, we thank you for the moon above and the stars out there. And we thank you for blessing every single person. They've come from all different places. God, we know that you are the Savior of the world, the light of the world. And we thank you so much for being ours in every way. We thank you, God, that you're visiting us here tonight. We ask for decisions for all of us to go deeper and to have more understanding about who you are, who our Savior is. And Father, I pray that you bless the worship, the message, and in the hearing, every single person will be blessed by what we're going to say tonight. We thank you, God, for your blessings on us. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
All right. Merry Christmas. All right. Yeah. We're excited just to worship tonight and just to celebrate the birth of our Savior. Amen. And we went ahead and posted the lyrics earlier on the Facebook page. So, Christmas carols are awesome, but they're a little more wordy. So if you want to check that out, you can sing along with us. And amen. All right, here we go.
Sweet hands of joy, in grateful praise.
God, we just thank you tonight for your son, that you sent your only son to come to this earth and be human and ultimately to die on a cross for our sins so we can be made right with you, Father. God, we just thank you for that tonight.
Shepherds in whose eyes they live.
voices of angels.
Hallelujah.
So we're going to read baby Jesus' birth story. So if you all would read with me, if you want, in Luke 2, we're going to read from the very beginning. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census took place while Quirinus was governor. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now were there in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. And there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord had made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things in her heart. Then the shepherds returned and glorified and praised God for all the things that they had heard and seen, and it was told unto them.
That's the story.
We wanted you to know that there's hot chocolate and apple cider if you need something to warm you. We are so excited that you're here for our first ever Eve of Christmas Eve service. The Lord has blessed us this year in so many ways. God has just opened up doors for us here on the farm. We would love to invite you on Sunday mornings to come to church here. We have church every Sunday from 2 until 3 o'clock. So you're invited to come to that. Also, I wanted to say thank you to our worship team and also our Angel and Joseph and Mary and all the kids that came out tonight. Everyone was kind of in traffic tonight, so we're sorry we got a little late start. I wanted to just start off by saying that Christmas Eve is always a time that I remember. It was a hard, hard Christmas Eve, and that's the story that I'm going to tell you, but it ends well. My dad, on the month of Christmas, in December, he passed away unexpectedly. And so it was a really, really hard month. And it got to Christmas Eve, and I hadn't done any Christmas shopping. And I hadn't done a lot of the things that you're supposed to do because it had been so hard. And so on Christmas Eve, though, I wake up. And I was like, "Lord Jesus, God, I ask that you will help me. Help me to be able to be filled with joy today. And Lord, would you just give me your glory today?" Because we have 5 children and we have company coming for Christmas lunch. And so I wanted the Lord to be my peace. And I wanted the Lord to be my comfort. And so I opened my Bible and I felt the Lord's glory right there as I was reading it. And then I went downstairs, and the door started to knock. It was like 7 o'clock in the morning, and I thought, who would be knocking at your door at 7 o'clock in the morning? And so I opened it, and it was a little girl, and she stood there, and she said, "I came to play with your daughters." And she said, "I'm so excited. It's Christmas Eve." And I said, "It's really early. You should go back home and maybe eat breakfast with your family." And she said, "No, my mom told me to come." And so she said, "Your daughters told me that I could spend all Christmas Eve with your family." And so I said, "Well, they're not even awake yet. We don't let our kids out of bed until 8 o'clock. And And so I said, you should wait. And so she said, I'll wait down here for them. And so anyway, her noise woke the kids up. And so they all started to play. And my heart was still like grieving and having a hard time. And I had to keep on asking the Lord, God, help me, Lord. I want to have your joy today. I want to have everything that you would have for me. And so the kids got louder and I decided that I should leave to go shop or something. And so I left the house, and when I got back, the house was a wreck, total wreck. The kids had like thrown everything that we had and owned all over the whole house. You know what I'm talking about. And so I thought, oh my goodness, Jesus, help me. And so it was time to start cooking. And so I had made these cookies, and I put all of our girls' names on the cookies. And I saw the little girl that was there, and I decided I would put one of the cookies with her name on it. And so it was time to eat. And I called the mom, and I said, hey, you know what? I could bring your daughter home for you if you like. You know, it wouldn't be any effort or anything for me like to pop her in the car and just bring her right on home. And she said, oh, no, we're getting so much work done without her. How about you keep her there? And so I thought, oh, my Jesus. All right. So I made the dinner and put all the food on the table. And then the little girl saw her cookie with her name on it, and she said, oh, my goodness, I cannot believe I got a cookie with my name on it. She said, I have never had a cookie with my name on it. And I said, really? And she said, how about you do something for me? How about you make another cookie with my name on it, and then I can bring that one home to show my family that I got a cookie with my name on it, and then I eat the one that's sitting here. And I thought, oh, my goodness. And I said, I think we have another cookie. I'll do that for you after dinner. And so we sat down, and we started to eat, and everybody was really loud. And again, I had to say, Lord Jesus, would you help me just to be able to experience the joy here of this time where we're celebrating you? And so the dinner was over, and every Christmas Eve, we always read Luke chapter 2, which is what Dale just read. And I looked at him, and I said, Dale, can you read it tonight? And he said, no, I think you need to read it tonight. And I said, I don't want to read it. He said, no, I want you to read it, Sharon. I said, I don't want to read it tonight. He said, no, you need to read it, Sharon. Anybody ever told you need something and it's basically telling you you're a little off tonight? It always gets on your nerves, right? Right? It really does. So I took the Bible, and I didn't have the right attitude, and I started to read Luke chapter 2. Now, what happens when you read the living word of God? You can have a bad attitude, and when you read the living word, all of a sudden, because it is living, it changes your heart. It changes your heart. And all of a sudden, I felt the whole Christmas story living in me. And so we finished reading it, and I looked up, and I was really good at that point. And the little visitor, the little girl that had come over, she said, what? Jesus was born in a barn? She said, what's the rest of the story? And I said, you don't know the rest of the story? She said, I don't. And I said, well, I can only imagine before Jesus came and was born in the stable that all the angels were in heaven, and they were like, how is God going to send his only son to earth? Maybe he'll send him like a blazing light. Oh, and it is going to astound all of the earth. Or maybe he'll send him in like a general on a big horse, and he'll be like royal. And or no other angel said, no, I bet he'll go in like as a wise philosopher, like amazing everybody. And when all of the angels saw Jesus as a baby in the manger, they all started to sing. And the little girl was like, wow, can you imagine all the angels singing in heaven? I said, I know. It's such an exciting story. I said, then after Jesus was born, he started to grow, and it says in Luke chapter 2 at the very end of it that when he was 12 years old, that his parents, Mary and Joseph, had taken him to Jerusalem. And while they were there, he kind of got lost. They were going, getting ready to go home, and they're looking for Jesus, and they can't find him. They found him in the temple, and he was teaching the older people, the lawyers and the scribes. And there, I can only imagine the conversation that they might have had there. Little boy, what's your name? Well, on my mama's side, my name is Jesus. But on my daddy's side, my name is Emmanuel, God with us. Little boy, how old are you? Well, on my mama's side, I'm 12 years old. But on my daddy's side, I'm from eternity to eternity. Little boy, what are your future plans? Well, on my mama's side, I'm going to die on a cross. But on my daddy's side, I'm going to rise again on the third day. Oh, the little girl said, he dies? The little baby in the manger dies. I said, but he rises again. I said, and all who believe in his name, who receive him as their Lord and Savior, he comes to live within them. The Holy Spirit comes to live within. And you get to spend all of eternity with Jesus. And she said, even me? And I said, even you. So we were finished with our story, and our girls ran upstairs to go get their pajamas on, and she ran upstairs. I said, hold on, I need to call your mama now because you need to go home. And she said, not yet. And so I said, all right. So she ran upstairs, and all of the girls came back downstairs with their pajamas on, and so did she. And so she said, what's next? I said, well, we open presents. We all open one present tonight. And I'm thinking, oh, my goodness, I got to go get her a present. So I ran upstairs and got her a gift that I got the other girls and wrapped it up and put it under the tree. And it came time we were unwrapping, and she got to the present with her name. She said, I got a present with my name on it. I said, yes, you did. She said, this is a great night. So we finished our presents, and everybody went upstairs to go to bed. And I said, hold on. I need to call your mama because she's got to come get you now. She said, let's not end the night this soon. So she said, how about we just do the snuggle thing, and then I just stay a little bit longer. So we went upstairs, and we snugged the girls as a bug in the rug, each one. And I snugged her as a bug in the rug. And I said, now, honey, when you get snugged in the bug, as a bug in the rug, you are glued into place. And you can't get out of bed. She said, really? She said, I want to be glued right here. And she said, that's a good thing. I said, well, how about you're going to miss all the Christmas at your house? She said, I don't care if I miss all the Christmas at my house. This is so much fun. So I said, all right, here it goes. We're gluing you in. So we glued her in. Was snug as a bug in the rug, and then I went downstairs. I sat on the sofa, and all of a sudden, I started thinking again about my dad, and Lord Jesus, why? Here at Christmas time. And I started to cry, and just sitting there, and about that time, the little girl came down, and she said, oh, why are you crying? She said, was I too loud tonight? I said, no, actually, you were loud, but I'm not crying because you were loud. And I said, did you know that my dad died this month? And she said, no, I didn't. And she said, I just want to ask you one question. She said, tonight when you were telling the story about Jesus, she said, you said that he would come inside of you when you say that you believe, that you want him to be your Lord and Savior, that the Holy Spirit comes in and he gives you power. She said, I think he hopped in. I think he hopped right on in because I feel different. She said, what I want to know is how do you make him stick? How do you make Jesus stay? How do you make Holy Spirit stay? I said, let's pray. So I prayed and I said, Lord God, I just ask that you will come inside this little girl. She said, he is. I already told you that. She said, he is there. Just tell him to stay now. I said, Lord, God, this little girl wants you to be here forever. Give her that assurance, Lord, to help her to know. And Lord, help her to live for you all the days of her life. I said, honey, at the end of the book of Luke, the very last verses, it said that Jesus came so that we would have eternal life, so that we would have his spirit that would live within us all the days of our life. And I gave her a hug, and she ran upstairs, and her parents didn't come until midnight to pick her up. And I sat there, and I thought, you know what? No matter what we have going on in our lives, no matter what circumstances you're going through, no matter what circumstances I'm going through this year, no matter what we're going through next year or the next year, we need to focus on the love of Christ. We need to focus on the joy of our Lord. He is the Messiah. He is the Son of God. He is fully God and fully man. Oh, the joy when he fills us. So the next day, I started to teach her more about the Lord. And did you know that in the book of Matthew, that Jesus is our Messiah? In the book of Mark, he is a miracle worker. She said, a miracle worker, what does that mean? I said, oh, he can do anything. And when you are his child, you can do anything. Oh, in the book of Luke, he is the Son of God and Son of Man. He is that baby who came in the manger. And John, he's the Lamb of God. And Acts, he is the ascended one that brings the Holy Spirit with fire. Oh, hallelujah. In Romans, he's our Redeemer. In 1st and 2nd Corinthians, he is the yes of all the promises of God. Every promise that God has said, Jesus is yes and amen to the promises. Oh, hallelujah. And in Galatians, he is our deliverer. In Ephesians, he is the resurrected Lord that gives us resurrection power in Ephesians chapter 1. In Philippians, he is the name that's above all names. In Colossians, he's our all in all. In 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, he's the soon coming king. Oh, he's going to come on the clouds. It's exciting. He's going to come on the clouds with the voice of an archangel, with the trumpet of the Lord, and the dead in Christ are going to rise first, and all who remain, who are with him, will join him. And that's where we'll be forever. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And 1st and 2nd Timothy, he's our mediator. And Titus, he is a faithful pastor. And Philemon, he is our friend that sticks closer than a brother. And Hebrews, he is the blood that washes our sins away. Oh, he's a righteous king. Oh, hallelujah. And James, he's the great physician. Oh, we need a great physician on the earth so people aren't fearful of COVID. Oh, we got a great physician. Because even if we die, we get to rise again with him. Hallelujah. And 1st and 2nd and 3rd Peter, he is the chief shepherd. Oh, hallelujah. And 1st and 2nd John, he is our mediator. And Jude, he is the Lord coming down with 10,000s of saints. Hallelujah. And in Revelation, he is the King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whoa, Jesus, you are worthy, Lord, for us to celebrate your birth. You are worthy of us to celebrate you every day, no matter what the circumstances are in our life. God, you are worthy. Oh, tonight, if you haven't made a decision to follow him, tonight is the night. You want the resurrection power in you. You want the friend that sticks closer than a brother. You want Jesus. Oh, if he is saying come, and he is, say yes to him tonight, because he is the light of the world, and you do not want to live without it. Tonight, if you have not been living the way you know you should, and you're a believer, tonight is the night you say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, I am sorry that I have not put you first. Oh, you are worthy of everything. I surrender all. You know what? The Magi brought expensive gifts. We don't have those. We've got something better to give Jesus. We can give him the frankincense of our joy this season. We can give him the myrrh, Lord, of our worship and our adoration of him. Oh, and we can give him the gold of our full surrender. Oh, hallelujah. Lord God, I thank you, Lord, for every person on this property and every person listening. Lord God, I just ask right now if there's one person that needs to receive you as their Savior, Lord, that this moment would be it. Would you pray this prayer with me if that's you? Jesus, Lord, would you forgive me of all my sins? Lord, would you receive me, Lord, into your kingdom? Lord, I want you to be my King. I want you to be my Savior. I want to live with you for all of eternity. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We're getting ready to have our candlelight service now. And we are so excited for you to join us. If you don't have a candle, raise your hand and someone will bring a candle to you. And Dale's going to lead us in a couple verses.
I'm sure you all have heard this story many times. I hope that this story that Sharon just told you will really open your heart to understand how important Jesus is and how important it is to share his love to people who are just around us. They're in our own neighborhoods. They're our next door neighbors. There's something that we have, if we have joy, that we have to give it to people around us. And that joy is not something you make up just because you want to be happy. That joy is because Jesus comes to live at your house, and he comes to stay, and he jumps in when you want him to stay, and he never leaves. So praise God. I'm reading out of John 8:12. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. So we here today want you all to have the light of life. And the Holy Spirit is willing to come to be at your house, inside you. And all of us here on stage and many in this whole field, everybody's experienced Jesus in that way. But we want to invite you to have him be your Savior. And we're just going to light the candles to show our support of the light of the world, that we are the light of the world. Jesus calls us the light of the world, not only himself, but he gives us the light as well. So if you have fire is being sent around different parts of the audience right now. So if you all hold your candle up, ready to receive that fire so you can be the light of the world. We're going to sing a couple more worship songs. Christmas songs, our worship team. Thank you guys for being out here in the cold with us. Praise God. We also have an area up here at the stable. If you all would like to come up and have prayer for anything in your life that you want to have prayer for, we'll be willing to pray for you and also to bring blessings to your life. So get ready to worship again in the open sky with the shepherds. Hallelujah.
child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
Lord, for catching me, and David too. We're just going to finish out our candlelight service tonight. Again, if you all have any need for prayer, come on up. We have many people that will pray for you. This is our church, Glasgow Farm Church family here tonight, a lot of people. And we're just going to pray right now for the Lord to bless us in this Christmas season in a way we've never had blessings before. So, Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus for everything you're doing for us. We thank you, God, for ministering to us tonight. We thank you for your word that has come alive. We thank you for your testimony that you have been present in our past and you're going to be in our future. And God, we thank you that you are our Savior, that you laid down your life to come to earth, to be born as a baby, raised up as a perfect man, and then as a Savior to pay for all of our sins. And God, we thank you that you rose again to heaven and are watching every single thing that goes on in our life right now. Lord, we pray for your peace to reign in our life. In the midst of the struggle of all of the things going on in America, in the world, you are our peace. And you are our Savior. With any problem we have, God, we lay these problems before you right now. I pray that every single person will receive that you, Lord, will take all of their burdens and give them to you. We thank you, God, for this moment in time that we can be here all as a family, as a group, on different from different places. And I pray, Lord, that you would bless this Christmas season in a way that you never have before in every single person sitting here tonight and all of their families. And I pray, Lord, that you would breathe into our lives in a new way for us to be your children at this moment in time. Lord, we thank you for being here tonight, and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Merry Christmas, everybody. All right.